Oh, that's a really difficult question because it's it depends on the poem, right? So the poem, it decides its own form and content in a way, because so a good poem for me, a poem that I get that would excite me, it's got to have sound. It's got to sound nice because, you know, it's a lot about the music of the words. It has to open up something new. It has to open up some new meaning. And yeah, I think that's the two main things of those, yeah. I think it would be pretty much the same, except that maybe for really young readers, the sound takes precedence over the meaning, and I think children really love funny stuff, so when I write poetry for young kids, I tend to write really funny stuff, so because I've seen that I enjoy it as well, but I think the sound is important, because you see how children respond to rhythm and to, you know, to sounds in poetry. It's really, you can really see that, the way they move to rhythm when you were in poetry. I loved poetry actually, because it was taught very boringly in school. You know, they mostly destroyed it for you because they would, you know, tell you the meaning word, expect you to tell them the meaning word by word and line by line, and, you know, break it up into figures of speech and this and that. But somehow I loved poetry, so I used to read up my poetry book as soon as it came from, you know, as soon as this class began, the year began, I would read all the poetry in the book because I loved poetry. So it was a huge part of my growing up, I think, reading poetry. But it stopped somehow after I grew up. I don't read that much poetry now. I think I mostly write poetry for children. When I was younger, of course, we all go through this phase of writing poetry, and it was used to be really bad stuff. But when I started writing poetry for children, that's where I think I actually found my meter, in a sense, because I found I enjoy writing nonsense. And nonsense is somehow easier to write in poetry. Nonsense prose is really very difficult to write. And so most of my poems are absurd and nonsensical. It's at least the ones that are published. I think I hide the ones that are not nonsensical. So that's, for me, it's because it's the fun of it. It's just the fun of, you know, sound and meaning and lack of meaning when it's nonsense. That's I really enjoy it in a way that I don't enjoy anything else. That comes, you know, ideas are all over. When you're about to write, then, you know, the ideas come from different places. So there are some of my poems where the ideas come from something that's really happened. Sometimes it's just come from a kind of what-if thought. So, you know, there's this book, this poem, which was a book also called Today's My Day, where it's about a girl who's fed up of grown-ups telling her what to do all the time. So that came from a what-if thought. What if one day she could do what she liked? And so that day, anyone who tells her what to do turns into something weird. So, you know, so that's, sometimes it's that, sometimes it's something that really happened. Like tiger on a tree, really, it's from something that really happened. Catch That Crocodile, if you've seen it, is also from something that really happened. So, I mean, it's different things. And excuses, for instance, is, it's something that I've been thinking of for a long time, because, you know, children make the strangest excuses. And so when I had to work with Gabrielle for a book, I just thought of, let's try that. And because of, and sometimes when it's picture books, it's also the pictures, the style of the illustrator also affects the poetry. So it's kind of, that's a very nice kind of tension that happens between the two. So anything, actually, ideas come from anywhere. something about writing poetry that frees your mind from logic, in a sense. It kind of helps you think differently, especially if you're rhyming. If you're trying to rhyme, it helps you think differently. So when you're trying to rhyme, you can either become really inane and, you know, rhyme it, use words that are there just for the rhyme and they don't make sense, or you can use that to kind of think very off the wall. And that's the fun of writing poetry, I think. So I find it in a way easier to write poetry. So because I find it frees my mind. If, you know, when I'm writing poetry, my mind is freer because of the rigidity of the form, I'm able to play more with meaning. The odd thing is, at least I don't know how it is in other countries, but in India, poetry for children in English doesn't sell at all. So nobody publishes it. It's really sad. Very, very few books. I mean, there are the picture books in verse, that's there, but books of poetry for children. But on the other hand, if you really watch children, when you read to them, they respond so much to poetry. Whereas with prose, there has to be a story and there has to be a thing. But with poetry, it's a much more instinctive response. So I think that's the difference between prose and poetry. With poetry, children respond very instinctively. Yeah, so like I said, in English, it's not. I think it's partly because of the education system that, you know, teaches poetry in a way that children begin to look at it and think, oh, you know, it's not a fun thing. But having said that, in the Indian languages, there's a lot of poetry. So in languages like the languages that I am familiar with, because I read them and I know of them, Malayalam, Marathi, Bengali, Hindi even, there's a lot of poetry, and there are a lot of books of poetry, and there are a lot of poets, children's poets, you know, who also are actually well-known poets, award-winning poets for adults as well, but they also write children's poetry. I think that shows how much importance poetry is given in any language or culture, when people who write serious adult poetry are also writing children's poetry, and that happens a lot in definitely in Marathi, definitely in Bengali, also in Malayalam, but not, I don't know about the other languages. See, we've got so many languages. So, I mean, extrapolating from that, I think Indian languages, we do have a lot of poetry for children. But in English, maybe not that much, which I guess is also because it's not the native language of children. So children respond so much better to their own language. So I think there's that difference. So it started, like I said, I had been thinking for a long time about a story. I mean, you know how stories are, sometimes they just sit inside your head for years. So it had been a while since I'd been thinking about something with excuses, and the elephant was definitely there in that thought, because I remember actually hearing about a child who couldn't go to school. This was in the hills. So in the hills in India, you sometimes have elephants in certain parts. There are actually elephants who sometimes wander out of the reserve and come onto the road. And it has happened once. I remember either reading about it or somebody telling me about it, that a child couldn't go to school because there was an elephant on the road that day. So we were thinking that if somebody gave that excuse in school, it would never be believed, you know. So from that thought, this idea was there that, you know, I wanted to do a book about excuses. So how this book happened was that Gabrielle came to India to do a residency kind of thing with Tara, and she, Geeta, who's a publisher, asked me to work with her. So we were chatting and we found that, you know, we had a lot in common in terms of her style is really wacky and So that kind of resonated with the two of us. So then I came back to this idea. And because Gabriel's style is so wacky, the book became wackier than it would have been otherwise. So it became really nonsensical. This is a book written by a very famous Indian poet, actually. Adil Jasawala is one of the biggest Indian poets in English in India. So what happened was a friend of ours, so when I saw these poems, he'd not written these poems for young people. But of the poems he'd written, he felt that these were somehow young, you know? So which is how the collection happened. And I think if you read those books, read those poems, first of all, Adil's poetry is beautiful anyway. And then these especially, I think, they address the kind of things that young people go through when they're struggling with identity, they're struggling with expectations, you know, of people expecting them to be a certain way and it goes against what they want to do. So it has all of that. So it really addresses the things that young people, you know, we're talking about young adults mainly, go through. So, and the writing is really, really beautiful. So if you read the poems, you'll know they're very, very deep and very, very beautifully written. And so when you asked for a poem, a book of poetry, it was the first one that came to mind. I have to say that it's just so heartening to have a festival for poetry, because especially for young people, because it's something that we really need, and I hope that there are more of them.